giving us the rundown from the sideline, David Aldridge. So the opening lineup for the Heat, they've got Jimmy Butler, Lowry out there with Steph. Then there's Achiuwa, and it's Adebayo in at center. And for New Orleans, Ingram the three and Zion the four. And then there's Stephen Adams. Then it's Turner. Thank you.
lifeless at the defensive end. I mean, especially inside. They've really got to pick up that interior defense.
Williamson dishes to Ingram. No doubt he's struggling right now from the field. Let's see if he can get it going this quarter.
Out to the wing. Now, here's Adebayo. Butler on the wing. Shoots over Ingram. Kept alive. Stiff kicks to Butler. Shoots over Ingram. Shot clock at 5. The shot by Adebayo, no good.
Hard to figure out how he doesn't knock that one down. No defender in sight.
Covered by a step. He can't get that one. Great D that time from Adebayo. He dishes it to Lowry. Butler against Ingram.
Displaying intensity right off the opening tip, especially on the offensive end.
Tell you what, forget about easing into the game. They came out with guns blazing.
Williamson left side. Goes up the baseline, and it's Miami with the rebound. Adebayo passes to Steph. Adebayo against Turner. The kick outside to Butler. Releases from the wing and drills it. Butler's got 11 points.
Their play on both ends has been superb. We'll see if they can maintain the momentum.
And, you know, nothing like getting an opponent on the ropes early. You love that if you're on that side of the scoreboard, and they are landing some haymakers now.
Ingram outside. To get something going. No basket with that shot. Having trouble finding his range. He's 1 for 5. Out left of the wing. Stiff the pass to Adebayo. And Adebayo throws it down.
And they have owned the paint so far. And the score reflects
it. And you know, establishing that physical dominance early gives you a big mental edge too. Don't discount that.
Wasted no time on that one.
And their balanced effort at both ends has hushed this crowd.
Yeah, you said the key word there, balance. I mean, their big lead owes as much to their defense as their offense.
That first time out of the game called for New Orleans.
Well, it's been an express lane to the rim. Coach can't be happy about that.
And, you know, I think he's going to tell them simply, we have to show more fight on the interior. That's the top priority right now.
Alexander Walker. To the left wing, here's Segura. One up, one down. 2 points with his first shot this game.
He does not lack for confidence. He shouldn't. I mean, this guy is a dangerous scorer.
Here is Steph. Here's Nunn. Loads it up for Adebayo.
Nice, silky finish on the alley-oop from the stupendous feed.
That sequence couldn't have been executed any better.
Guys, I hope we get to see a few more of those.
Bledsoe with it. Here's Alexander Walker. Passes it to Segura. Here's Alexander Walker. He feeds it to Hayes. Down the clock. Punches a 3. One up, one down. shot this game.
And they don't want to get in a habit of giving him open looks from three. First quarter steal, but not who you want to leave open.
Pass to Chris. Here's Adebayo. A good finish at the rack off the slick feet. Adebayo's got 10 points in the game.
Well, you got to be in awe of what he's doing this quarter, actually destroying the opponent.
None against Bledsoe.
And they've won the rebound battle so far, and it's translated to a scoreboard.
The effort level they've had has been outstanding. Hard to keep a team down when they play with that much energy.
Attacking in transition, the most consistent way to generate easy looks.
Yep, exactly. And if there's any opportunity for early offense, you've got to push it and push it every time.
Zagorac passes to Bledsoe. Kicks to Hayes. Locks up the alley-oop pass. The shot by Alexander Walker, no good. Hayes by 18. Akpala, the pass to Chris. Here's Akpala. He's covered by Brown. Here's Akpala. Here's Stiff. Oh, and that one, no question, forward it down.
Give them credit. Offensively, they've been the more efficient team.
You know, it's been all high percentage shot form so far. I mean, just the kind of execution you want in the first half.
Here's Brown. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up. This is his first trip to the line tonight. The first free throw is good. Tyler Hero, he's checked in for Kendrick Nunn. Here's Hero. Lost contact on the shot, and now a three-point play chance as he'll head to the line.
That's the 10th straight point they've given up in the paint.
And, you know, it doesn't matter how good your defense is on the perimeter if you're going to allow easy ones inside like that.
The Heat shooting their fourth attempt at the free throw line right here. So far. Pelicans trail by 21. Bledsoe outside. We've got 123 left in the first. That one good for two.
It'll take more than that to stop Bledsoe now. Come on. I mean, this guy excels at taking contact and handling punishment on the way up.
Adebayo passes to Hero. Stolen by Bledsoe. Here we go, one-on-one. Here's Alexander Walker. And it's blocked by Stiff and out of bounds as the Heat gain possession. And now another look at that mobile one-block defensive performance.
And it's a different kind of defense teams play in the postseason. More in-your-face, physical, high-energy plays like that one.
Shua. No points in the game yet for him. A shot by Alexander Walker, no good. The Heat leading by 23. Burke with it, Eric Bledsoe covering. Burke, the pass to Chris. Pass to Steph. Six on the shot clock. Here's Burke. Steph, the pass to Burke. Here's Hero. And the three off target.
And you could tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
Bledsoe dishes to Brown. The pass to Segura. Here's Bledsoe. Rebound by the Heat. Achua's got six rebounds here tonight.
And you know what? He's just not on his game. No doubt about it. Their deficit isn't totally on him, but he has not been an asset for his team.
Hey, I'm stating the obvious here, but he was very comfortable taking that shot. Not a defender in sight.
Pass to Alexander Walker. Williamson left side. Chris with the rebound.
You know, sometimes making it difficult for him to finish at the rim is all you can ask for from the defense.
A dunk by Achua.
And guys, he's not an easy man to stop when he's got the rim in his sights.
Never has been, never will be. He is a determined finisher.
And guys, I like the fact that he chose the one-hand tomahawk slam because you get a little higher when you go off one hand and one foot.
Heat have gone three of their first five shots to drop here in the second quarter. Burke with it, now guarded by Bledsoe. Here is Steph. 11 points in the game. Back to Burke. Five on the clock. Releases. And it's Miami with another.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball movement.
Really a prime example of the difference in how these teams have operated offensively. Much more individual play at the other end.
Passes it to Alexander Walker. Here's Williamson. A rebound by Steph. Steph's got seven rebounds in the game. Hero passes to Burke. Throws it up high. Oh, a nice defensive play to disrupt the alley-oop. And here we go. Fast break. Williamson's got it. Miami's gone 1-2 on three pointers here in the second quarter so far.
Defense! Defense! Defense!
Now, here's Burke. He's covered closely to the left side wing. Shot clock at six. Shot's good by Hero.
Oh, great ball movement there.
Here's Bledsoe. He's got six. Brown outside. Pass to Bledsoe. Here's Williamson. And the dunk by Williamson.
So good to see Bledsoe setting up guys like that. I mean, especially when they're wide open and they've got the better shot.
And Miami calls their first time out of the game. For Tyler Hero, and it's Kendrick Nunn in for Trey Burke. Now the Heat with it. They're on a 14-6 run. Nunn looking around. That one goes in.
unwilling to let up, even for a moment. That's his killer instinct, just fanning the flames.
Yeah, I love the fact he doesn't play the score. He just keeps coming, attack mode. He doesn't know how to step off the gas pedal.
Down low. Here's Adams. It doesn't go for him. Now the Heat take it the other way. To the paint. Shot's good from Butler. Butler's got 13 points.
Easy to see why Butler gets so much respect for his competitiveness. I mean, he thrives at finishing through contact.
And the pass to Williamson. Shoots over at Chua. And it's Williamson missing.
Boy, just cannot buy a bucket, guys. I'll tell you what, that's a painful quarter for him, and it's painful for me to watch, too.
Clearly, he's one of the best there is in the business when it comes to making that lead pass.
The Pelicans shooting just 31% in the game.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
A basket counts and one. He'll go to the line with a chance to make it a three-point. And so it's the Miami Heat with a massive lead of 30 points here at the end of the quarter. Their defense has been active and effective. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Kevin, thanks. Here with Jimmy Butler. Jimmy, you have come a long way in this league. When you look at your career now versus when you came in, how different is it?
What's different? I think on the floor, I'm supposed to do a lot more on both ends of the floor. And off the floor, I think it's still the same. People recognize my hair.
Well, it is a unique style. Jimmy, thanks a lot. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks for the great interview, David. And we'll be back for the third quarter of basketball following halftime. Seeing a tremendous game from Jimmy Butler.
You just love the patience in that first half. Waited until he got the look they wanted.
Well, you know what, guys? It was all about efficient offense, not rushing things. Taking your time, finding the best shot on every possession.
Ingram the three and Zion the four. Then it's Turner. And then there's Steven Adams. So that's the group out there for New Orleans.
They've shown some strength in the paint today. Their work on the boards has been impressive.
Guys, that's putting it mildly. I mean, they've been absolutely dominant.
The Heat have been a perfect 8 of 8 at the line. Free throw good. Adebayo. Turner with it. And stolen by Kyle Lowry. Finish, and Adebayo throws it down.
Don't take your eyes off Bam. When he comes off the floor, he gets up and the slams are just too good to miss.
Ingram. Lowry covering. Now Ingram. Over Butler. And it's Ingram missing.
You almost have to assume he's going to knock those down when he is that open.
Pass to Achua. To the middle, here's Butler, and slam dunk by Butler.
And you know, Butler knows his team depends on him, relies on him to fill it up and put it in the basket, and he's an outstanding scorer with a really versatile arsenal.
And so it's Turner with it. He brings it up for the Pelican. Up the floor, and Butler gets it to go. Butler's got 4 points now in the quarter.
A nice start to the second half. Just one miss in their first five attempts.
They're struggling to keep up.
And we'll see if they can turn things around, Kevin. On this trip, they can't continue to come up empty.
Ingram finds Adams. Right wing pulls up from the corner. That's good for Williamson. On the assist by Adams. Williamson's got 13 points. He'd have gotten four of the first 5 second half shots to fall. 80% since the break. Passes to Butler. Score the basket for his 10th make. 10 for 12. 83% accuracy.
And now you see them starting to really work the ball inside.
Pelicans shooting around 41% on the night. Outside Turner. Down to five on the shot clock. And that one is good. Ingram.
Ingram really graceful with the catch and shoot jumper. His lightning quick release allows him to get off his shot in no time.
Stiff, the pass to Butler. Pass to Stiff. Good ball movement here by Miami. Turner comes to double team. Shoots. That one a little long for New Orleans. They've gone 2 of 3 from the field to start the second half. Ingram outside. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line. It's going to be on Bam Adebayo.
Love how Ingram toys with the opposition. Just is unflappable, drawing contact easily on these kinds of shot attempts.
And he makes the first.
So just asking to get burned if you do.
There's the bat.
showing that he can score through just about anything.
Pass to Achua. Here's Adebayo. And Adebayo throws it down.
And although an undersized center, more than making up for it with some serious hops.
And he gets it to go. 6 points for him. Here is Steph. He's got 14. Passes it to Achua. Wants to get it to Adebayo, window.
Just Mr. Reliable again here today, Kevin. I mean, they need his points, and he's producing.
For New Orleans, they've gone 5-7 from the field in the third quarter. Let's see if they can keep it up. Pass to Williamson. Ingram outside. Six to shoot. Kicks it out to Williamson. Good with the triple.
Just enough coverage to bother that three-point attempt.
Second chance shot, and they call the foul, so he's got the and-one chance here to make it a three-point play.
Yeah, coach's pet peeve there. No box outs.
Those are free points you're giving away. You got to work harder on the glass.
The Heat have been exceptional shooting free throws tonight, going 9 for 9. Catching up on the changes with Miami. Chris, he's checked in for Adebayo. Tyler Hero comes in for Jimmy Butler. And it's Kendrick Nunn in for Kyle Lowry. And here are the Pelicans now.
And here's that intense defensive look.
Yep, and that's the only way to play full court man-to-man. You know that from your days at UNLV. 100% intensity a must.
Williamson in the post. It's tipped. Here's Hero. He's got 12. Back to Nunn. Oh, and there's the alley-oop. The dunk by Achua. That gives him the double-double. 11 points and 11 rebounds.
And really a good job spotting his teammate near the bucket and then just pinpoint passing for the finish.
They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions. Right now, they need a basket.
They need this. It's hauled in by Hero.
He's having a tough quarter scoring the basketball and able to help him close this gap.
Here is Steph. 14 points for him. Here's Chris. And he gets the basket. Officials blowing the whistle, so a chance at the line for one more.
Not a lot of resistance on the inside, and they're taking full advantage.
The play in the paint has gone almost entirely all their way.
Find the lane. One shot.
Young, rangy big man. Chris possesses a nice skill set, and I think the potential to be a terrific player in our league. No matter what looks they get, they just can't convert to stop this run.
And, you know, they've got to be careful, because this is when the team concept breaks down and guys start playing hero ball.
Nunn can't get it to fall. New Orleans gone 1-2 from beyond the arc since coming out of the break. Here's Bledsoe. 5-on-3 break. Nunn with it. Picked up by Brown. Nunn, that's good. Nunn's got his second bucket of the night.
And those are the kinds of plays that are just killing them right now.
Priority and goal number one has to be tightening up the defense. They can't afford to give him open looks.
Sakura, he hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
Oh, how about the deft touch right there, guys?
He just guided that ball back up and in. Just a fingertip touch on the ball.
That's exactly right. No need to catch it when you've got the kind of soft hands that he does.
Yeah, just a simple one-hand flush.
I think he got a few more inches on his vertical by going with the spike.
Yeah, I agree with you. That's what it looked like to me. I mean, he was way up there.
The pass to Alexander Walker.
Oh.
the Pelicans will retain possession. And Miami making a change here. Akpala's checked in. A tremendous mobile one block that we had to see again. Great send back.
And bringing that postseason intensity, so key. These plays can change the trajectory of a game.
And the Pelicans with possession here. Bledsoe passes to Zagoras. Just five to shoot. Bounce pass from Bledsoe. Brown drives in. Good, and Bledsoe gets the assist. Brown's got 6 points.
Well, I like the way they're sharing the ball, and Bledsoe right in the middle, spreading it around.
Here is Steph. He's got 16. Pass to Nunn. Goes in there.
And the jump shot has been a dimension of this game where they've had a clear advantage.
They keep pulling up and watching them go down. It's a really nice thing to see.
Bledsoe outside.
Different
three-point shooting since the half has been about as good as you could ask for.
And now's the time for them to step on the gas pedal. Don't let up. Keep letting it fly from deep and build that lead. Play through the finish line, not to it. Keep the pressure on.
Miami's gone outside a lot tonight. 17 times, in fact. 7 of 17. And here is Williamson. Ingram outside. A 17-footer. And that one hits back iron. He'd have gone through the fourth quarter shooting 50%. 7 of 14. And Cauley Stein throws it down.
That is room service delivery from right there. Was a sweet dime to create a high percentage shot.
New Orleans has gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
Even though they're down, they are putting on a show at the free throw line.
Yeah, they're making the most of their opportunities at the stripe, and they'll need to keep it up to take the lead.
First free throw is good. A different look for Miami. Atala's checked in. And it's Kendrick Nunn in for Trey Burke. And so he hits both.
And just a better job of getting to the line here in the second half. Didn't get there once in the first.
None with it. Feeds it to Cauley Stein. And that one, good. DeLon Wright, he's checked in for Stiff. For Cauley Stein.
And Cauley.
We're making a switch here. Stiff is checked in. The Pelicans have got a pretty good rhythm going offensively, shooting 8 of 15 for the quarter. And there is a whistle. That's going to go on Jackson Hayes. That'll be his second foul of the game. Miami's gone 2 of 5 on three-point shots since the end of the third quarter. Stiff, the best of silver. Here's Akpala. Over to the left wing. Heat moving the ball around. Here's Silva. Sinks that one from the post.
A great feed, and that assist gives him a triple-double. You gotta love that kind of player, able to get it done in just about every passing.
Patton kicks to McDermott. Bledsoe outside. A three. A shot, no good. And the Heat going the other way now. Here's Stiff. Wow, that makes him a perfect 10 for 10, double-digit perfection.
This is some kind of performance we're seeing from him today. He has yet to miss a shot.
And it's good off the back of the rim and in. Stiff's got 16 here in the second half. New Orleans has gone 1-3 from outside the arc since we've reached the fourth quarter. Bledsoe passes to Patton. Inside, here's Johnson, and it's Johnson with the jam.
And not the prototype power forward, but he has tremendous athletic ability.
Here's Akpala, and a beautiful feed leads to a monster jam.
And this offense is in a perfect rhythm, and you can see how they're finishing their plays.
Boy, this is borderline ridiculous. I mean, every single attempt finding the bottom of the bucket.
Pelican shooting it well here in the fourth quarter, 50%. Pass to Patton. He kicks it to McDermott. And Bledsoe has it in the corner. Pocket four. 13 feet away. And it's Miami with the rebound. Akpala's got his fourth rebound in this one. back to none to the paint. And that one's good by Stith. Stith's got 29 in the game.
Big miscommunication on defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes advantage.
Boy, the defense looks shell-shocked. I mean, they're on the ropes right now, on their heels. Yeah, he just flat-out tricked that one, missed it, and has no one to blame but himself.
Pass to Cauley Stott. Here's Akpala. To the inside. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. And the first one drops. From the strike. There's 1:17 left in the fourth quarter.
And hold on to your hats, folks. This has been a whirlwind championship finals thus far. Obviously an important hard-fought victory tonight for Miami.
And this was one that never really was in doubt, but an all-around dominant performance. And you kind of thought that maybe we were going into the game.
Yeah, there was a sense of that, and man, they just pretty much blew them right out of the water. A clinic was put on display here today.
And you know, looking back at all the contributions tonight, it was a really phenomenal all-around game for the kid.
You know, getting a triple-double isn't easy because I never had one of those, but somehow he made it look easy, just showing you how versatile his game is.
Trains it from beyond the arc.
Maybe he's not one of the elite sharpshooters, but even still, that's not a shot that he can afford to get.
Stith, the best is silver. It's deflected. Here's Alexander Walker. It's a 4-second differential between the shot clock and game clock. None. It's blocked. Now McDermott. Defended by none. Got a hand on it. And they get it back.
Clearly. Wow.
Yeah, he took a shot there. Earned those free throws.
Clark Kellogg, and David Aldridge. This is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. See you next time.